Hi, everyone.
Glad that you joined us for this work in progress showing of ForceField, our new duet we've been working on for a couple months. We are in Labrador City right now. We're at Dancing Performance Studio. Big thank you to the studio for providing us the space to make the work. We're also teachers here. Maybe some of our students are out there. Hello.
Hi.
We want to acknowledge that we created this work in Labrador, the traditional lands of the Beothuk, the Innu, and the Inuit peoples. Very grateful to be working on this land. And what else can we say about our performance tonight?
We are going to be performing for 20 minutes after the showing. Feel free to stick around. We're going to have a bit of a talk back. If you have questions or anything you want to ask, you can ask us on the Zoom link and also on the YouTube link. Yeah, you can write in your thoughts and your questions.
Yeah, we'll be looking at all that too. So, and it's available on YouTube for, it's gonna be there for the foreseeable future. So feel free to look at it again or share it with others.
Yeah.
All right, I think we're ready to go.
We hope you enjoy.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you to Dawn, our tech person for the evening. She's waving. So, where is everybody?
Thank you so much for joining us tonight. It really means a lot during these times of COVID, and I want to just take a moment to think about what is happening down south in America. I think we are very lucky to have someone in power now that
is a good human.
Is a good human, a good citizen, and a good role model. And yeah.
So if anyone has questions, we can open this up to a talk back, but we can also just say a little bit about the inspiration behind the piece. We started thinking about this during lockdown, and we were thinking about how bodies are now so dangerous. Bodies are now
almost toxic.
Yeah, and we wanted to look at that and look about how bodies are seen as very vulnerable right now and dangerous, and look at how we're all part of this choreography of trying to stay safely apart. We're also watching a lot of kind of apocalyptic films and TV shows during lockdown, including Chernobyl, which was the music for this evening was from that TV show. The HBO series, I need to remember the name of the composer, Hildur Gildnerson. Yeah. But we do have a composer that'll be working with us for the second phase of this, Kevin Williams, based in St. John's. I don't know if he's out there. Hello, Kevin. So we will be having different music, but we wanted to use this to inspire us for the first phase of the project. Yeah, the music was by Hildur Gildnerson. Is the name.
Sorry if we pronounced that wrong. We also are very fortunate to work with Karen Kasia later in this process. She's an inspiration to both me and Jen. And her work really is in touch with touching. So for her, this is such a huge contrast in the way she's actually even living. Like us all, and working in the studio, not being able to touch. So for her, it's what does it mean to touch someone anymore? And that's part of the process we tried to incorporate ourselves.
Yeah, you'll notice we dealt a lot with non-touch and how far we are apart, and then saving all the very, very touchy parts till the end, where it's almost like intrusive. It almost seems violent when we finally do come into contact. And of course we have the mask inspiration at the end. Yeah.
There's also a little bit about we've just watched a fantastic movie, Tenant.
Oh yes.
So part of the work that we have created is that it plays with reverse time, going back in time, wanting to be in the past, mm-hmm. per se. And so we played a little bit with that as well.
Yeah, and kind of looking at mirror images of time, looking backwards and looking forwards. So yeah, Charlene, do you wanna open it up to any questions people may have? If you're joining us on YouTube, I guess this is the end of our YouTube stream. If you wanna hop onto Zoom, you can chat with us here. We'll be here hanging out.
Yeah. And I think there will be some, if you are on YouTube, you can write your questions below, I believe. Mm-hmm. And the ArtsNL community will send it over so we can answer your questions.
Yeah. So thank you, YouTube people, for tuning in. Thank you, ArtsNL.